In this training, we will cover three examples of auto-applied retention label policies. Part 1 will cover using auto-applied policy with a retention label that leverages sensitive information types. This training assumes you have worked with creating and applying retention labels and/or policies. Refer to the compliance video, Introduction of Retention Labels, if a refresher or overview understanding is needed before proceeding. Start by going to compliance.microsoft.com, select Information Governance. If you do not immediately see this option, select Show All. Information governance is organized into 5 tabs, but we will focus on the Labels tabs. A label must be created before you can add the label to an auto-apply policy. Check the Labels tab on the Information Governance page to verify if a new label needs to be created or an existing label can be added to the policy. Click Create a Label to start the new label wizard. On the Name Your Label page of the wizard, give the label a name that reflects the label's purpose. Add a description for admins and users to inform of the label's intention. Remember to turn the retention label from off to on. The labels page allows you to configure how long you want to retain the document once that time is up, what action to take place after this time frame. Other options include on the apply the label, when the document is created, or modified, or trigger off an event such as an employee resignation. Before creating the label, verify all the settings meet your intended requirements. You can always edit any of these settings should a change be required. After the label is created, you will see it listed on the Information Governance page under the Labels tab. Now let's add the label we just created to the policy by clicking Auto Apply a Label. We add the label we created earlier to our policy by selecting Choose a Label to Auto Apply. We can search for the label or the tag we created, or simply select it from the list of tags. Remember that only one tag can be added to each policy. As before, should your requirements change, you can simply click Edit to go back and choose a different label. In this example, we're going to select the first option, allowing a label to apply to content that contains sensitive information. With over 100 sensitive information types, we can use one of the built-in templates to customize the type. We are choosing the medical and health template with HIPAA selected, allowing the document to be protected should it contain any PII or personally identifiable information and medical terms. Maybe we need to add banking information to our template along with the HIPAA sensitive content. We click Edit to add this requirement to the policy. We have the option to trigger on some or all information types. To fine-tune the trigger, we can change the instance count and match accuracy. If you want to discover more patterns of information, you can lower the match accuracy or the confidence level, which then requires less matching or evidence. We can also add additional sensitive information types to the default templates, allowing customization for your organizational requirements. Simply click Add and choose the sensitive information type to complement Social Security number and Drug Enforcement Agency number. Our organization requires the U.S. Taxpayer Identification Number for medical records, so we select it from the list. We could also use the search function to narrow the scope. We can verify the added U.S. Taxpayer Identification Number to Social Security Number and Drug Enforcement Agency Number sensitive information types. We click Add to repeat the process or click Remove on a highlighted type to remove it from the list. We can also create custom groups that include sensitive information types. We add a banking info group and sensitive information type ABA routing number to the new group. On the Name Your Label page of the wizard, give the policy a name that reflects the policy's purpose. Add a description to inform the policy's intention. Let's unselect Exchange and OneDrive as we look to apply the policy to only SharePoint sites. We can add multiple SharePoint site locations to the policy by clicking Choose Sites. After providing the URL to the SharePoint site, we select it from the list of sites to include the location in the policy. We confirm the site or site locations are added to the policy or click Choose Sites again to add more locations. Now we show the sites and the locations added to the policy. Before creating the policy, verify all the settings meet your intended requirements. You can always edit any of the settings should a change be required. Lastly, we confirm both the label and the auto-applied policy are created. For more information about Microsoft Information Governance, including compliance documentation, visit the link below.